Today I bring to you an episode called First Dates. It was pretty cringeworthy, and I wasn't planning on watching it. I just stumbled across it by accident, and I just couldn't take my eyes off it. Let's get on with it. What's the show about?
This summer, there's a restaurant with a difference.
Good evening.
Hi, Juliet.
How are you?
Give us a cuddle.
Everyone in it will be single and on a real first date. Cameras will catch every moment in the search for love. Will any of these first dates lead to a second? And will anyone find their perfect match?
Oh, shit.
First dates are quite nerve-wracking, aren't they? You don't know what to say, you don't know anything about them. Anyway, that's what happens with the show, so with that in mind, let's have a look at some of the females that are up for grabs.
I worry about choking and dying.
Someone who likes to talk about death.
I just stopped drinking lots.
And an alcoholic, brilliant. Alcoholic date, okay. You're gonna have a good time. Who else we got? Come on, there's someone, there's gotta be a good person in here, surely. Someone you'd wanna go to a restaurant with. Who have we got?
Well, I'm a vegetarian, so.
Oh, yeah?
Fucking vegetarian, brilliant. Can we swap? Fuck's sake.
First dates don't normally go to second dates because we normally have too much to drink and then we have sex.
Firstly, mate, say it with some enthusiasm. Come on. Honestly. And secondly, is that all you're after?
Changing my attitude to women because I don't want to be that guy at the end of the bar who's chatting up all the young girls, you know. It'll look awful. So it's time to settle down.
All right, fine, you've changed. I get it. Let's see if we can sort you someone out.
Yeah, I'm an Essex boy, so.
Essex?
Yeah. So you're from Liverpool, yeah?
Did you know that already?
It's just the accent gave you away. Yeah, and you took me wallet already.
Awkward long pause there. You probably shouldn't have said that. You're not doing too good so far, mate. You may think there's nothing worse than saying something you shouldn't have done and then having to endure a long pause. But there is. Imagine not even being able to understand your date.
Facebook.
So what?
If it's Facebook.
What?
Facebook.
What's that?
Not royalty.
Royalty?
Facebook.
Fistful?
If it's not royalty.
Do it again.
Loyal, of course.
Oh, loyalty. Yeah, you're looking for loyalty. You won't find that here. So, can we get the bill, please?
35 next week.
Are you? 35? Oh my god. That is old, isn't it? Oh my god. So what are you doing for your 40th then?
Where's my 40th? Can we get the bill, please?
I'm afraid so. I have quite manly interests.
Otherwise you will be gay.
I mean, that's every straight guy's worst nightmare, isn't it? You go on your first date, you're trying to make a good impression. Are you gay? Brilliant. Can I get a fucking bill, please?
And then at the same time, I know the sort of girl that I want long term. So I'm thinking, do we go out and have a couple of cheeky drinks, maybe end up in bed, and then I'm back to square one. But yeah, we'll probably have a couple of drinks, and because we're like mates already, aren't we? And then we'll just see how it goes from there. The mates touch each other there.
Is sex on the agenda when I'm 68? Definitely on the agenda.
Go on, son.
It's a trial and error thing, I think, at 68. I mean, I've been on my own now for 3 years, so I don't really know how I would react.
You'd probably hit the roof. I wonder if his date would be up for it, though. If I was him, I'd try and look for some sort of sign.
Have you read 50 Shades of Grey?
There's your sign. Have you read 50 Shades of Grey? God, if that's not a sign, I don't know what is. He's well in.
Wow, you're a feisty one, aren't you?
You can't have a giggle.
You have.
Life will be very boring if you can't have a giggle.
Indeed you do.
If you can't have a giggle. I know what you mean. I'm not stupid.
So what's grabbing your fancy?
The dressed cock sounds quite nice.
Dressed what?
Oh, that's a bit too far. There's a lot of swearing in this programme, isn't there? We ain't seen nothing yet, because this next person, he loves a swear word. Check it out.
So now I'm looking for a lady to kind of settle me down, one that contained the beast.
I'm not saying like tomorrow, but one day I would like to get married and have children, you know.
Okay, so for Will to be in with a chance with Faye, he's gonna need to be a bit of a gentleman, I presume.
You know how shit smells? That's how it tastes. So it tastes like I said, if you take a big whiff of shit, it's like eating that.
Okay, you're allowed one slip up. Maybe you should just try and tone down the language a little bit. And just sit back a bit, let her lead the conversation, and then you respond appropriately.
Do you know what's Corrie?
I have done before once.
Big Easter.
There's loads of paedophiles on there, aren't there, now?
No, mate, I said appropriately. Rein it in a bit.
In the last year, so many people have come out of the woodwork. And you wonder why now?
Yeah.
It's like Savile. What someone should have done, they said, just look at that guy's face. He's definitely a paedophile. Well, I don't think they're allowed to convict someone just by the look of their face.
Did you not just hear what I said? Talk about something else.
Yeah, I phoned my brother in there. He goes to me. He goes, is it good? It's Jay. He goes, what's she like? I said, she seems nice. He goes, what colour hair has she got? I said, she's a blonde. He goes, blonde, yeah. He goes, if you finger her. I said, it's not like that, mate. I said, I don't think there's going to be much fingering.
Dude, you won't even get a second date. You're a lost cause. I'm going to check in on the other couple and see what's going on there.
It was different.
So it's pretty clear this date isn't going too well. I mean, he's not interested, that's for sure. Let's skip to the interview and see what happens in that bit there.
I think it went really well, yeah. I think it was really good to sort of meet someone new and have a conversation with someone that you've never had before. And I think meeting people from sort of different parts of the country and different cultures and different backgrounds and just different everything, someone that you wouldn't normally meet in sort of day-to-day life back home. So I think it's really nice, yeah.
Yeah, no, I do. It's nice, no, it is. It's nice to meet someone new and, you know, it was enjoyable. I had a nice night.
Yeah, it was really, really good fun.
That was awkward, wasn't it? Oh, that's what I love about this programme, the cringing moments. They're so good. Let's have a little check-in on Will and Faye, shall we?
Excuse me, mate, can we get the fucking door, please? Come.
You're right, round here I am.
Will may not be right for Faye, but she's hoping there's someone watching tonight that could be. Her next first date could be with you.
Ready? Okay. So tonight wasn't the most perfect of dates.
Cool, so what are you looking for then?
I'm still looking for someone. No really preferences, if you didn't talk about poo.
Don't talk about poo yet, good, got it. Anything else?
That'd be a great start.
Say it. All right, good. Looks like I meet the criteria. Easy, don't talk about poo, sorted. So I'll see you next week for our date then, Faye. Just a little date there, I'll date you. Just put that down there. Anyway, that's enough about my love life. Let's talk about you. Did you see the show? What did you think of it? Did you not see the show and you saw this one, but you thought, oh my God, it looks so good, I'm going to watch it myself. I want to know everything. Talk to me about your experiences on your first dates. I want to know about your worst first date ever in the comments below. Brilliant. Stay tuned for some outtakes. Bye. I'm going to go and log on and trees. We're not having a go at vegetarians, but they are pretty shit, aren't they? Vegetarian, nope.